In Brazil, only 1% of trans people have a formal job. They're often thrown out of their homes, shunned by society, and have to face many hurdles to find a formal job. However, universities and entrepreneurs are now coming forward with special programs to help Brazil's transsexuals get formal training, which will then enable them to get a job and live with dignity. Here's a report.
Rochelle Rangel was rejected countless times in job interviews. "We can't hire a transvestite," she heard a manager of a multinational in Sao Paulo say. But thanks to training programs and virtual platforms that emerged in recent years, 34-year-old Rochelle and other trans people are landing their first formal jobs.
"We are going to my workplace at Bulia Bar, where I managed to get my first formal job, thanks to a training course I took at UFRJ called Transwaiter. And today I am an ambassador for this course. But I encountered many difficulties to get this first job."
Rochelle was a sex worker, a hairdresser, and later moved to Rio, where she learned about the special program run by the Federal University of Rio. It trains trans people to work in bars and restaurants. This is how she got her first contract after 15 years of trying.
"Besides the importance of the dignity of having a formal contract, which is very rare for a trans person, it allowed me to dream again and inspire the other trans people who see me working here to find a job. Many trans people send me messages asking for job openings."
Rochelle é uma colaboradora sensacional, assim. E eu acho que é uma forma das pessoas entenderem que as pessoas trans são tão gente como a gente, são capazes de fazer o que qualquer uma pessoa faz.
The project also has online courses to educate business owners and managers on LGBTI+ issues. Another job placement initiative was founded in Rio by stylist Andrea Brazil, a 48-year-old transvestite.
"Raras são as que têm mais, muito raras. Mas isso está começando a mudar, com projetos como o nosso, como o projeto da Transempregos. As empresas estão começando a mudar esse olhar."
One of the biggest challenges has been breaking the prejudice in the business environment. New job platforms and forums are slowly taking shape, connecting eligible members of the trans community with businesses which have suitable openings.
"É outra vida. Para mim, nossa, a ansiedade que eu tinha, depressão, tudo isso foi embora, entendeu? E eu sonho muito mais que isso, entendeu? Por isso eu vou continuar estudando, voltei a estudar, coisa que eu saí de...
Brazil is one of the most dangerous countries in the world for transsexuals. In the year 2020, 175 trans people were killed, one every 2 days. Their fight for justice continues. Bureau Report, Weon, World is One.
Weon is now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.